And now, another My Inner Thoughts video review. Here's your chance to take a peek inside my head. Hopefully, it will give you good insight and improve your decisions. Now, I can't say everything is true to reality, but I can say it's the way I see it. So, take what you will. I've got my new EcoWorthy solar tracking array system up and running after watching several YouTube videos. I took the good and bad from them all and I made my own video. Hopefully this will make your install go a lot smoother. All right, so what they want you to do on step number one is put these expansion bolts into the concrete through the main mass. I wanted to make it stronger, so I bought these 10-inch galvanized anchor bolts that are a half inch wide. I also bought this 16-inch by 4-foot concrete forming tube. I fished the cables up through the tube. It takes 13 60-pound bags of concrete to fill up the tube. And here we are leveling it off. To prepare the mass from dipping into the concrete, I placed these two metal rods I had, along with scrap wood, to support the weight, as the 16-inch tube is too weak to support it. With the mass in the correct orientation with the sticker north facing north, I then lowered it down, leveled it, and let it rest overnight. I did not care for the bright white, so I'm going to spray paint mine green. You know, it sure would make life a lot easier if they would label this pole north, south, east, and west all the time. You know, I'm just saying. How tough would it be? It would save me a lot of thinking. Alright, so we got rod B on there. Now we're going to put rod C on top of it, using the latch and cotter pin. Now, there was a lot of confusion on the internet as to which side to put this rod D on. This is the newer upgraded manual. However, it doesn't show the bottom of that rod D. There are two holes and they must face west. I only know this because I randomly had it facing east. Now I gotta take the damn thing off. So, okay, let's take a look at this thing. You can see the two holes there, not on the other side. They're there. And now when we put this thing on, we just have to face it west, which the instructions do not point out. All right, so we'll just touch this up a little bit with some paint and then move on to step number five. Alright, so once again, the instructions do not point this out. However, there are two pre-drilled holes, and you need to face those facing downward, and also out toward the west. But before we attach it, we need to attach the support arms. This will support four solar panels when we attach this pair. Later, we will attach another pair, and those will hold two solar panels. All right, so we're on step number six. We're gonna install the actuator arm. This is a small one. It'll be going on the south side of the pole. We just need to install the two linear actuator stands. Alright, so the instructions have it with the actuator motor facing downward. I really don't care for that. I think the actuator arm would last much longer with the motor on top, eliminating debris such as dust, snow, and ice from getting inside the shaft. And now we can install the larger actuator arm. It's going to fit nicely on this north side of the pole and attached to the earlier D rod that we faced the correct way. There, that looks pretty nice. We're starting to get somewhere. All right, so we're on to step number eight. But really, these two photos should be flipped around because you have to do that one step before you do the other step. All right, so we're going to attach this arm underneath the existing arms, and those will support two solar panels. This step would be a lot easier if these actuator arms were not connected, so I'm going to disconnect those so I can swing the assembly easily to my reach. I don't like doing things when they don't make sense. I wish people would think when they write these manuals. Okay, so I can easily get at things now. I am a perfectionist, and I just want to make sure everything is nice and square. I can easily bend it out at this point if it's not. Okay, so now we can attach this second pair of arms. And I have this all nicely centered. Okay, let's put on this last one now. And oh, see how nice and easy it is to swing this thing around now with those actuator arms off. It just makes life so much easier. The cotter pins that came with the unit were pretty cheap. I bought these extra, and these are some nice thick ones. So I'm going to take those other ones off and put these other newer ones on. So now both of the actuator arms can be attached. I also bought these metric rivet nuts to drill into the main post. This will give me some threads so I can mount an electrical box. The computer control box runs off of 12 volts, so I have a 12 volt line coming into here along with internet Cat 6 cable for any upgrades such as a Wi-Fi repeater or a security camera. And then I have two 10 gauge wires which the solar panels will feed back to the house. I can easily tap on to the 12 volt termination blocks if I want to add some LED lights later. All right, so now we're ready to add the solar panels. So that we're not fighting gravity, it's best to set the solar tracker array system flat as shown now. These clips hold the solar panels on the arms. Next, we will install the solar compass. This will tell the computer where the sun is so that it can face it. Everything is in place. Now we just need to connect the solar panel wires. We're going to connect them in series. The red hot wire coming from the house connects to solar panel number one. Then the black wire from number one goes to number two. And then the leftover wire from two goes to three. The leftover wire from three goes to four. Then four to five. And then five to six. And then the wire that's left, the black wire, will go to the house. So looking underneath, this is the red wire. And here is the red wire from the house. We're going to just connect those together. And now we have this extra wire over here, the black one. And we're going to connect that over here to the second panel. They'll just snap right in. And then just continue down the line. So here from solar panel number two, we have this wire left over. You just plug it into this one, into three, that third one into four, four and five. And then this number five one is going to stretch way down over to number six. So the black wire from the house gets connected to that last plug. Now, when the solar panel creates energy, it will send it to the house. 155 volts DC with 1170 watts. Mathematically, it's 8 amps. We're almost done. We just need to install the wind speed meter. If it gets too windy, the solar array system will go flat, which is the safest wind resistance position. And here you can see I installed it to the electrical cabinet. I think it looks kind of neat. I think I did a pretty good job jerry-rigging this thing. Well, we're all done out here. Let's go inside the house and see where this is all going to. This is a power supply that's 12 volts at DC, 30 amps. It supplies power to the solar tracker array computer. The power that is produced from the solar panels goes into this EcoFlow Delta Pro system. It has batteries inside and also uses house current to distribute power to items plugged in here. On the screen, you can see that the solar panels are now producing 980 watts of power, and I am using 0 watts currently to the items plugged in below. Well, that about wraps it up. Hey, I made a song for you before you leave. Does everyone like heavy metal?
I see people putting on sunscreen to block themselves from the sun's rays. I won't block you. I want the opposite. I want to grab you. Yeah, grab, grab, grab you. Morning comes and I put up a solar tracking array with six bifacial double-sided monocrystalline solar panels in series. 195 watts each, totaling 1170 watts and 144 volts DC and at roughly 8 amps. I know that's a lot to take in. I am almost done, but did you know it's gonna track the sun all day east to west? Harnessing the sun's photons as a packet of energy that vibrates the molecules that absorbs it. On a stage, you are the original Mother Nature's endless spotlight. Thank you for taking care of us, Dad. Your heart is so nice, warm and giving. You let anything, anyone grab you. I wanna grab you. Now I am gonna use you. Ha ha ha. Ha ha ha. Now I am gonna use you. Ha ha ha. My solar tracking array system is gonna watch you, and I am gonna use you. Ha ha. Nice to grab something and not get in trouble.